Pacey. What's going on, people? It's Casey from www.casey-sounds.com. Today's video is how to chop samples to use in your EXS24 sampler. So first of all, what you want to do is grab your sample. So your sample could be in your folder here. You just drag and drop. We've got my sample chopped and ready, so I don't need to drag and drop it in. So go to Logic Pro X at the top, hit key commands or hover over key commands, hit edit, type in split, and then you need to look at split regions slash events at playhead position, because this is going to allow you to, while the sample's playing, to hit whatever button you choose and just chop that sample. So for me, I've got the command and T's to allow me to chop my samples while the playhead is moving. So choose something that won't interfere with any other key command that you've got on Logic X. Okay, so now you've got that, you want to chop the sample. So we're just going to count 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, like, yeah?
Because I love you so. And before you let love go, remember true love just don't grow on trees.
Yeah, so that'll do. I'll get rid of that, the rest of that stuff there. And then I'll open up an EXS24. Click on edit. Highlight all those samples just chopped, drop it into the new window. It will tell you now that you've got 30 new samples, or however many samples you're going to drop in. Leave that as is, click OK. Then you want to go to new group, command and A. That will allow you to highlight all the samples, drag and drop into your new group. Then go to groups at your top left on the window, and then you want the polyphony at 1. So this will allow you to, every time you play, press one button or one key, the next key you play will override the last key. So when you click X, it will ask you if you want to save it. Save that sample. We just name this new sample. So now you've got that saved anytime you want to go back to that sample. So there you go, it's pretty simple. Now you're ready to just drop samples, chop them into your EXS24 and get creative. Now the cool thing about using the EXS24 sampler, now that you've got your sample in there, you can do all kinds of stuff. You can change the tuning. You can add some distortion if that's what you want to do. You can change the ADSR. Yeah, so there's all sorts of things you can do now. I hope this video has helped. If you need any more help, leave a comment or hit me up in my emails or on any social media site. Thank you for watching. Peace.